It's funny, the day, the minute, the second when you know what's happening. I personally didn't feel the physical pain, but the emotional pain of missing out on what could have been the most important day of my life is a burden that I've had to live with for 30 years. I left my wife the night before she went into labor. I think it was my fault. I heard about stress-inducing pregnancy, but only thought it was an old wives' tale. Whether I was to blame or not, I wasn't ready to have a kid. So I had to go. I shouldn't have left, but I couldn't have stayed. This is the story of what I've left behind and the bond between a parent and a child that I should have experienced.
Excited to see that baby. I don't want what you're selling. Go away.
No, it's Kim, your neighbor.
Oh. All right. Come in. I can't do this anymore. Goodness, this place is a mess. Are you okay? I'm here to see the baby. I brought diapers for the day.
Oh, Kim, thank you. I can't do this anymore, Kim.
Goodness, you all right?
Oh, thank you for the diapers. Would you please take the baby?
Okay, sure.
I haven't even used the bathroom. It feels like I haven't gone in weeks. I can't take it anymore.
I don't think she's taking a shower either. Are you gonna get that?
Just let it go. I could take her back, Kim. Thank you.
Sure.
Come on over. Why don't you have a seat? Would you like a cup of coffee?
Oh, no thanks. I really have to go. I just wanted to see if you were okay.
Really? Mm-hmm. You can't stay?
I really have to go. I'm sorry. I'll call you later. Oh my goodness, she needs a lot of help. Oh boy.
This is so hard. Oh, I don't know how I'm ever gonna do this. Well, really doesn't matter as long as I've got my baby. I remember what my mother used to say to me. I'll love you forever, I'll like you for always. As long as I'm living, my baby you'll be.
None of this overwhelming self-doubt would have happened if I hadn't left. I could have answered the phone and cleaned up, and she would not have to fear doing all this alone. This was one of my biggest mistakes. I missed a huge day in my daughter's life, and one ignored phone call ruined her special time.
Happy birthday, dear Sue.
Your cousins are here, and your cousins are here. What's the matter? You don't seem happy. You can tell me anything. Well, I love the presents. I just want something else.
Honey, these are great presents. I can't afford anything else.
No, it doesn't cost money, but never mind.
You can tell me anything. What is that?
I want to talk to Dad.
I don't know if that's a good idea.
But this time I'm turning 10. Maybe he'll answer.
But when's the last time he's been in your life? All right. I'm not promising you anything, but you can give it a try.
Thank you.
Okay. Go get my phone.
All right, where is it?
It's right on the counter now.
I regret this so much.
I'd like to hear it too, please. Put it on speaker. Love you forever. I'll like you for always. As long as I'm living, my baby will be.
Even when I was young and my younger sisters were dating, I was always making sure to intimidate the boys she brought home. I had hoped to carry the same overprotective manner over into my daughter's relationships. Unfortunately, Anne took over the position that I once envisioned myself in. Anne was the mother who texted her daughter 1,000 times just to make sure everything was going well.
Three open seats right there, right in front. Someone I should maybe know about?
Sorry.
Are they down there?
No. Hi, guys.
Huh? Hi, honeys. Oh, no, you're not. You're not Mikey and Sue, are you?
No, where's Sue?
Excuse me, pardon me. Hi, guys. I couldn't wait to come. Oh, this is great. It's kind of dark in here. Would you hold that?
Great. Here's an extra soda. Why don't you hold that for me?
Oh, so dark. I don't know why they make these theaters, so I brought another one for you. Too dark in here. How do you turn this up? Here you go. You took my seat. Could you sit over there? I like being right in the middle. It's a big night out.
So good to see you, Mikey.
You
I'm
too.
So excited. Oh.
Popcorn, Sue?
No.
Now, yeah.
What a fun time together.
Needs a little butter. Want some?
I'm good.
A salt? Butter?
You know, the problem is it gets in my teeth. Those kernels. Right in my teeth.
Oh, dear. Kernel got stuck. Gum? No gum? Gum?
No, thank you.
What's wrong with you, kid? You don't eat?
No.
Oh, can't wait for Lilo and Stitch. One of my favorites. Gum?
No, thanks.
No? Oh, my nose is running. Oh, the cold outside is terrible. Can't open the gum. What, huh?
I'm good.
Half?
No, thanks.
What, you kids don't share? Why are they gonna start the movie?
You know I'll love you forever and like you for always.
Blah, blah, blah. I don't care.
I don't know what it was like for her to raise Sue alone, especially during those teenage years full of fighting and anger. Sue should have had two parents in her life so that they could both feel guilty for Sue's hurtful words, not just one of them.
So we're just going to meet up at the mall? Yeah, if you go to his house after, that works perfectly. Yeah, I'm going to leave in a couple minutes.
Oh, don't worry about her. She can stay home alone. It doesn't matter.
Yep, I'm going to leave now. Bye. I'm leaving. Bye.
What do you mean you're leaving? You're not going anywhere tonight.
Yes, I am. I'm meeting up with my friends.
Sue, you're a senior, and I know that. But you need to be home tonight.
Exactly. I'm a senior. I'm not staying home alone on a Friday night.
Even though you're 21, you're my family. I want you home tonight. We need family time.
No, that's not happening. I'm meeting my friends, and I'm not coming home.
You're the only family I have.
It's not my fault you made Dad leave. You did it to yourself.
Don't bring Dad into this.
You know what? I hate you. Oh, my God!
Don't you remember I'll love you forever? I like you for always?
As long as you're living, my baby will be. I do not!
The good outweighed the bad, regardless of the fighting. Sue is now 30 and pregnant with her first child. I am still a coward and can't bring myself to be there for the birth of my grandchild. I didn't attend her wedding, so what sense does it make for me just to show up out of nowhere? She married the love of her life, and it's obvious that she's happy without me. If I could go back and change everything, I would. I miss my wife and daughter more than anything in my life. I didn't get to watch her walk down the aisle, move into a new house, or marvel over the news of a baby. I'm disappointed in myself and understand why my family favors life without me. I don't blame them. I just wish that I had done things differently. Maybe there's one thing that I don't mind missing out on, and that's having to watch Ann suffer. The doctors think that old age isn't being good to her. Her body is shutting down at an abnormally early age of 63. If I had been present, I probably would have felt guilt, thinking that maybe it was my fault, but maybe it's my absence that's responsible. She worked too hard when I was no longer around, and that might have sped up the aging process. I feel guilty either way.